Good morning, students. Myself, Lata, is assistant professor from Department of ECE SJB IIT. We'll be handling embedded controller lab for you people. In this lab, we are going to have two set of experiments. In part A experiments, we are going to study about the assembly level language coding of ARM Cortex-3M M3 processor. In part B experiments, we will see the interfacing experiments where we are going to use embedded C language to interface the external devices to the ARM Cortex-M3 processor. Now today I will be teaching you how to execute the assembly level language coding using ARM Cortex-M3 processor, and the software which we will be using is Keil version 5 software. In party experiments, we have two experiments, simple experiments, which we are going to study in the syllabus. The first experiment is multiplication of two 16-bit binary numbers. As we know, when we multiply two 16-bit numbers, the result is always a 32-bit number. Now, this is the program which is showing you the multiplication of two 16-bit numbers, which is stored in some particular memory location. Now we are first, this is just a comment that I have. Now we are creating an area for the program and the code is read-only code. We are entering the code. Now this is the load instruction which loads the register R0 with the address of the memory. So the address of this memory location is 0x470H. So this address is loaded into the register R0. So we are setting R0 as a pointer for the memory location. Now, once the pointer is set for the memory location, now we are supposed to load the data which is stored in the memory to the corresponding register. We have 12 general purpose register that can be used for the implementation leaving R0. So general purpose registers ranges from R0 to R12. So R0 is used as a pointer now, so I can use any of the remaining 12 registers for my application. So I'm choosing two registers R1 and R2 for the multiplication operation, and the result is stored into R2. Now what I'm doing here is I'm storing the higher byte first from the memory location R0 to the register R1. So we are loading the first number, then after that I'm loading my second number which is stored in the memory location at the corresponding address given by R0, that is loaded to R2. So R2 is loaded with the second number. Now MUL is the multiplication instruction which is used to carry out multiplication between two registers. So we are multiplying the content of R1 with R2, and the result is stored to the register R2 itself. Now again, the whatever result I've got has to be moved to the memory location. So the higher byte first, it is moved from the register R2 to the memory location pointed by R1, and so on. Now once the multiplication is done, we are telling that it is switched. You are supposed to switch now to the memory location here, then we are terminating the program. This is what the logic of the program is. Now we'll see how to execute this code using Keil version 5 software. Now I'll go to the program now, execution of the program now. Now in order to execute your code using the Keil version 5 software, you can see an icon which is displayed in the desktop here. Double click on this icon, your software tool will open. Now we need to create a new project. Under that project, we are supposed to create the assembly level language code that I want to execute. Now if you have any previous program, better close it. So what I will do is, in order to close the previous project, I'll go to project, close project. So it will clear your previous project whichever is opened. Now go to project, new Microvision. So always make a habit of creating one folder with your USN name, and in that particular folder you need to always create your subfolders to store all your required files. Now I'm going to desktop. Here I'll create one new folder with some name. You can give any name. So in the beginning, give your USN number. Then for each of your experiments, when you create your subfolder, you can give the experiment name itself. Now I'm creating a new folder, and the folder name I'm giving it as Part A. So open this. So here I'll be giving a name for my project. The project name I'm giving it is MUL. I'm saving it. Now once this is done, go to legacy device database option here in this particular window. Here type LPC2148. Select this particular device for part A experiments, and for part B experiments you are going to use LPC1768. We'll see that later. Now it will ask you whether do you want to copy the startup file for your project. Give no, startup is not required for this. Now here your project will appear with a subfolder as target and source code. Now the important thing what you need to do is you need to configure your target according to your requirements. Now select this, right click, you will get an option called as options for target. Now just check whether your device is selected as LPC2148. Then go to output, select this checkbox create hex file, then go to target, select use microlib, and go to debug and check whether it is in the simulator mode or not. Now once this is done, give OK. Now your target is configured for the simulation. Now what I need to do is I need to create my assembly level language code. In order to do this, you can see an icon called as new control N or use control N, or click on this and a new editor window will open like this where you need to type your code. I'm just copying the code which I have with me. So type the code here. Now once the code is typed, click on this option called as save. You need to save your code in the folder where which is created already. So I'm giving the file name as MULA16.asm. always remember that the file whatever you have created, it has to be stored with an extension .asm. click save. Now your file is saved. Now the other thing is you need to add your source file to the group. In order to do that, go to the option source group, right click, you will get many options like this. Here go to this option, add existing files to the group, select. So you know the folder which is created by you, go to that folder, there select all files, and the file name which I gave was MULA, so add it. I'm adding it, just close it now. So two files are added, remove it, remove one of your file which is not required for you. Okay, now here any changes if you make, you're supposed to save your file always. Now check your file for any kind of errors. In order to check the errors, right click on your assembly level language code, you will get an option called as build target, or press F7 in your keyboard. So since there are no errors, it is giving me the comment as zero errors and zero warnings. While typing you will get many kind of errors, so try to rectify the errors, then again save and then again build your target. Now my code is ready, I've checked the code. Now I need to execute my code. So in order to execute the code, go to the option debug, start bar stop debug session, and it will ask you evaluation mode running with code size limit 32k. Give OK. When I give this, I'll get other windows which is showing me the contents of the registers and the memory location like this. Now I know the address of the memory location where my data has to be given. So the address is 0x470s. Give the address, give enter. Now the content of that particular memory is 0. Now first, always when I give any value, the first value will be taken as your lower byte and the next value will be taken as your higher byte. So give 11, I'm giving it as 22. The next value what I am giving it is 33 and 44. These are the values which I gave. Okay, the value is given in the memory location. Now you can see an option called as step, or you can press F11. So this will execute your code step by step, or else directly you can go to debug and give the option called as run. But step by step debugging is very much important, because you will come to know the content of the registers in a proper way. So better always when you execute your code use this option. So click on this once. Okay, you can see first your R0 is loaded with the starting address of the memory location, right? Click the, again click, you can see that the value 2211 is loaded to the register R1. As I told you, first one will be a lower byte value and next is taken as your higher byte value. Then again click on, so your second value is loaded to your R2. The value is 4433, that is the value which I gave. Then click on this. Now the multiplication is done between R1 and R2 and the result is moved to the register R2. Now multiplication will be done and the result will be, now the code is executed. As you can see, the result what I have in my register R2 is 0913444D63. Since I am moving higher byte, only the value 4D63 will be stored into the memory location, the consecutive address after your inputs. Now first we are loading the lower byte 63 and then we are loading the higher byte 4D into the memory location. So this is how the multiplication is carried out and the result is moved to the memory location. I hope you have understood the execution of this particular code. Try to verify the result with some other values. We have come to know how to work with LPC2148 device used for assembly level language programming. Now these are the Viva questions pertaining to that experiment, where the question could be asked on definition of a microcontroller, application of microcontroller, how the microcontroller is classified, the differences between microprocessor and microcontroller, what is DMA. So these type of question can be asked as in Viva. So try to prepare for the question that can come on architecture of the microcontroller device, ARM3. Thank you.